yoga at the Benninghofen House, coming to you from the third floor tower apartment. I'm Becky, a little less hair than last time, and I hope you're all doing well during these uncertain times. I hope that you are using yoga, especially the breathing, to quiet the mind and stay present. When you find yourself stressing and worrying, remembering to come back to the breath, kind of let it all go. One breath at a time, one day at a time. Today we have a practice dedicated to lengthening, strengthening, and decompressing the spine. We'll have a little core work at the end, followed by a deeply relaxing guided meditation during savasana. So I invite you to turn off the outside world. Let's get started. So starting off sitting, finding a comfortable seat. So feeling free to sit up on a blanket to make sitting on the floor a little more comfortable, sitting up on a bolster, or even sitting in a chair. Taking the time to make sure you're comfortable so that you're not distracted during the breath work at the beginning. Inviting you to close the eyes. To watch the breath. Watching the inhales come in. Watching the exhales flow out. Scanning your body, scanning your mind for anything that you're holding on to. With each exhale, letting go. Letting go of anything not serving you. Being present with each breath. And when your mind wanders, just bring it back to the breath. Again and again.
Muscle.
joining your hands at heart center, setting an intention for your practice. Practice dedicated to love, hope, strength for the world and for yourself.
Breath in. On the exhale,
Folding forward, keeping your hands clasped, feeling that nice stretch in the chest. Deep breaths here, release your head. Shake your head no, shake it yes. Make sure your neck is relaxed. One more deep breath in. On the exhale, releasing your arms down to the floor, stepping back into downward facing dog. In the front, your fingers are spread wide, your wrists are parallel with the front of the mat, your middle fingers are pointing forward, kind of mushing your hands into the floor so your hips go up and back. Deep breath here, release your head again. Left leg up towards the ceiling. So in the front, we're pushing away with our hands. Deep breath in. On the exhale, bringing your leg down, your knee towards your nose, and then stepping forward, helping your foot forward if you need to with your hands, stepping forward in between your hands. We're going to pivot the back foot. Going into warrior two, so you want your heel in front, in line with the arch in the back. Coming up, left arm out in the front, right arm out in the back. Warrior two. Deep breaths. Checking in the front that your ankle is right under your knee. Looking down, your fingers, your knee, and your toes should all be in line. Fingers are spread wide. On the inhale, reaching the hands apart. On the exhale, sinking in the hips. Shifting out over the front leg, bending the front arm, bringing it to your knee. Back arm, the right arm up to the ceiling. Fingertips reaching for the ceiling. Looking up at the hand. If that is not comfortable for your neck, just looking down at the floor. Deep breaths here. On the inhale, reaching for the ceiling, on the exhale, sinking in the hips. One more inhale, reach. On the exhale, wrapping your arm around the back, opening your chest towards the ceiling, pushing with this arm that's down to kind of work your chest open to the ceiling, deep breaths. Deep breath in. On the exhale, slowly unwinding, bringing your hands back down to the floor, stepping back into downward facing dog, pushing away in the front. Couple full deep breaths here. On the next inhale, right leg up to the ceiling. And then exhale, bringing the leg forward, knee towards the nose, stepping forward in between your hands, checking that your ankle is directly below the knee. If the knee is going past the foot, then just move the foot forward. Now we're going into warrior two, pivot the back foot, checking that your heel is in line with the arch of your back foot, bringing your arms up. Warrior two. Right arm out in the front, left arm out in the back. Deep breaths, stretching, breathing all the way into the fingers. Leaning forward over the front leg, bending the front arm. Left arm up to the ceiling, looking up at the hand. On the exhale, sinking in the hips. Deep breath in on the exhale, wrapping the arm around the back, working the chest open to the ceiling. This is a great twist for the spine. Deep breaths here on the exhales, twisting a little more, sinking in the hips, grounding down especially through the back edge of your back foot. Deep breath in, on the exhale, slowly unwind, make your way back forward in between your hands, walking your feet forward to a forward fold, dangling here. You can grab opposite elbows, swaying back and forth, releasing your head and neck. Always have a little bend in your legs. Feet are active. You can pick your toes up, wiggle them, put them down. Bringing your hands to your shins, we're going to come up halfway. So taking the bump out of your back, shrugging your shoulders back away from your ears. Legs are active. Crown of your head and your tailbone are reaching in opposite directions. Deep breaths here. Breath in, and then exhale, folding forward, arms out to the sides, inhaling all the way up, watch the palms come together, exhale, pulling your hands down to your heart, standing tall in mountain. Again, inhale the arms down, out to the sides, watch the palms come together. Exhale, leading with your heart, folding forward, hinging at the hips. All the way down. Inhale up halfway. Exhale, fold. Arms out to the sides, coming all the way up. Exhale your hands to your heart. Again, lots of breathing. Inhale the arms up. Exhale, fold. All the way down. Inhaling up halfway, hands on the shins, or arms just straight down. Exhale, fold. Arms out to the sides, coming all the way up. Exhale, hands to your heart. Again, inhale the arms up. Exhale, fold. Inhale up halfway. Arching up, shoulders back, exhale, fold, arms out to the side, coming all the way up, exhale your hands to your heart, inhaling the arms up, exhale, fold, we're going to bring our hands to the floor and step back, downward facing dog again. Pushing the floor away in the front with your hands, fingers spread wide. Heels reaching towards the ground. Feeling a long spine. We're going to inhale the left foot, left leg up. So as the foot reaches up, the hands are pressing away in the front. Pressing the floor away so your leg and your foot can go up towards the ceiling. Deep breath in. On the exhale, bringing the leg through, up to your hands, catching the high lunge. Balanced on your toes and back, sinking in the hips. Deep breaths here. Exhale, bringing the back knee down, uncurl the toes, low lunge, making your back leg and hip muscle nice and strong so you can bring your hands up to your hips, shrugging your shoulders up, back, and down, pushing the floor away, especially with your heel in the front, to lift your toes up, and then place them back down. Deep ocean belly breath. Connecting to the sound. Inhale the arms up. Watch the palms come together. Inhale, reach top. Exhale, sinking in the hips. Little back bend. On the inhales, reach. On the exhales, sink in the hips. One more deep breath. On the exhale, your left hand comes to the knee. Your right hand to the back of the leg. the right. On the inhales, crown of your head up towards the ceiling. On the exhale, twisting a little more, using your hand to help you twist, looking over your back shoulder. One more deep breath in. On the exhale, slowly unwinding, bringing your hands back to the floor, making your way back to down dog. Deep breaths here. Always feeling free in any of these poses to use a blanket under your knees or an extra mat, some kind of padding. On your next inhale, right leg up to the ceiling. And then exhale, one fell swoop, bring your leg through, up to your hands, catching the high lunge on the other side. Balanced on your toes in the back, extending out that back heel, spreading your foot wide in the front, spreading out your toes. On your next exhale, bring your back knee down, uncurl the toes, low lunge. Again, making your back leg and hip tight, connecting your foot to the ground in the back, bringing your hands up to your hips, shrugging your shoulders up, back, and down. Breathing here. Bring the right hand to the knee in front, left hand to the leg in back, twisting to the left. Shrugging the shoulders down, back, inhaling, getting tall, exhaling, twisting, looking over the back shoulder. One more deep breath in. On the exhale, slowly unwinding. Making your way back to downward facing dog. I hope you're not too sad, but this is our last downward dog. So any little movements that feel good, get them in. And then we're going to bring our knees down. Then our hips back to our heels, stretching our hands out in front, bringing your forehead to the floor, resting in child's pose. Deep breaths here. Deep ocean belly breath. Feeling your body expanding on the inhales, feeling your back expanding with your belly. Connecting with your intention, feeling it in your heart. A few more breaths here. Thank you.
tightening up your legs, tucking in your belly, tucking your tailbone down. We're going to inhale up the whole body.
Deep breaths, feeling your belly, pressing on the floor on the inhale. One more deep breath in. Go up a little higher and exhale the whole body down.
A few breaths in between. Okay, we're going to get ready to do it again. So active legs, tuck your tailbone down, pull your belly in, and inhale the whole body up. Up and out. So you're trying to get longer. On the inhale, stretching the crown of your head and your feet in the opposite directions. Shrugging your shoulders back and down away from your ears. Hugging your elbows in. Deep breaths. One more inhale. Up a little higher and exhale the whole body down. Strengthening work is good, especially since a lot of us are spending a lot of time online, hunching over, looking at screens, bending in the opposite way, and strengthening our back will help undo that forward hunching that many of us, most of us have going on. We're going to do it one more time. Tucking the tailbone down, pulling the belly in, shrugging the shoulders back first. Inhaling the body up, up and out, and then rocking back to cobra. Shrugging your shoulders back, looking up, trying to get your top spine curving back. Deep ocean belly breath. One more inhale, go a little higher, and exhale the whole body down. Push in your hands. Up, back through table, back to child's pose. Knees can be wide, big toes together, forehead to the floor. Deep breaths here.
Long spine. chest, folding forward, bringing your hands down to the floor. We're going to inhale, arching up for the cow-shaped back. Exhale, fold. Inhale, arch.
Move my hair clip. I don't know. I have my hair anymore. Hug hugging the knees in, rocking them around. Whatever feels good, massaging out the lower back on the floor. Take your knees in a circle. All right, so we're going to do a little core work here to keep our core strong. So first we're going to keep our legs up. Bottom of the leg, the calves are parallel to the floor. Knees are right over the hips. Hands are down at your sides. Your palms facing down. So we're just going to inhale here with both legs up. And then exhale, extend the right leg down towards the floor. Inhale it up. Exhale, the left leg straightens and lowers towards the floor. Inhale it up. Extend the right. Exhale. Inhale. Exhale, the left. Inhale. Exhale, the right. Three. Inhale. Exhale, the left. Right leg. leg out onto the floor. So we're going to do a twist here. So bring your right hand to the knee, left arm to the floor, and then take a deep breath in. On the exhale, drawing your knee and your leg across your body towards the right into an easy twist. So scooching this around in any way that feels good. You can turn to look towards your left hand to complete the twist along your spine. Finding the twist that your body likes, and then finding your deep breath, your deep ocean belly breath, breathing all the way to your belly. On the exhales, relaxing and releasing into the shape, melting down into the floor. On your next inhale, unwind, hug your knees back in, wrap them around, holding on to your right knee, extend the left leg out, right arm comes to the floor, deep breath in, on the exhale, drawing your knee across, coming into the twist on the other side, scooching it around so it feels good. Looking towards the right hand, finding your deep breath. Savasana. I'll be reading a guided meditation. You can extend your legs out straight, your arms down to the sides, palms facing up. It's uncomfortable for you to lay on your back like this. If it feels uncomfortable, you could put a cushion underneath your knees, or you put your feet up on a chair to take pressure off the low back. Yoga allots a specific time for the body to repair itself in Shavasana. The pose allows any physical stress or lactic acid that has accumulated during the practice to be released. Lying on your back, shrug your shoulders down away from your ears. Gently rock your head from side to side. Separate your feet 10 inches or more. Let your feet fall open to the sides. Arms are down at your sides, out from your body, with your palms facing upward. Fingers are naturally curled. Gently close your eyes.
Make yourself as comfortable as possible and remain here. Allow your attention to be on the smooth, slow, serene flow of the breath. The exhale is cleansing and relaxing. The inhale is nourishing and energizing. Turn your attention inward. Mentally scan your body from head to toe and back again, pausing briefly to become aware of each area and to release any tension you feel there. When you discover tension, imagine sending the breath to that particular part of the body. Honor your areas that need a little extra healing. Pause on certain body parts a bit longer if you have pain, limitation, or emotional injury. Remember, this is a practice for body, mind, and spirit. Clear your mind of the past and the future, and when it wanders, simply bring it back to the breath. Let the whole body be soft, heavy, and easy, like you're melting into the earth below. Relax everywhere, letting your eyes fall backward, away from the eyelids, your tongue lightly resting on the roof of your mouth. With each exhale, feel the tension leaving your body, releasing all the body's toxins, waste, and negative energy. Make your inhales deep, soothing, and peaceful. Feel the space inside and around your body. Notice that as you relax and expand, every tension disappears. Relax the crown of your head and the brain, allowing both sides of your head to release toward the floor. Relax your forehead, eyebrows, eyes, eye sockets, eyebrows. Relax your cheeks and chin. Soften the temples, the jaw, your neck, and throat center. Relax from the shoulder joints to the elbows, to the wrists and fingertips. Feel the energy in the palms of your hands. Let the movement of your breathing loosen the shoulder blades, mid-back to lower back. Let all the wide muscles of the back release to the ground completely. Let go over and over again through the breath. Soften the heart center, the rib cage, the abdominal organs and pelvis. Feel yourself let go of any toxins with a long, slow, deep exhale. Feel healing energy entering your consciousness with a long, slow, deep inhale. Soften the hips, in and around the hip sockets. Then breathe all the way down the thighs, knees, calves, ankles, feet, toes, tips of the toes, and soles of your feet. thoughts and receive the serenity of the pose and the flow of the moment. Remain here, and when it's time to return, you'll hear three chimes. Exhale, relax. Thank you. how relaxed you feel, promising yourself you're going to keep some of this relaxation with you, knowing with a few deep, mindful, ocean belly breaths, you can feel it anytime you want. Joining your hands at heart center, releasing your intention, knowing the seeds have been planted. Remembering to come back to the breath often. Anytime you're feeling worried or feeling stressed, come to the breath. Quiet the mind and come to the present moment. Sending all of you love, hope, and strength. One breath, one day at a time. Thanks for practicing with me.